the most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of holidays long, long ago. There'll be much mistletoeing and faces glowing with promise of long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing of faces glowing, so be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Much mistletoeing and faces are glowing with stories we're sure going to know. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be holiday greetings and gay happy meeting, so be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time, yes, the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time of the year. So, is it the most wonderful time of the year?
It absolutely is the most wonderful
Fantastic.
Time of the year. We haven't worked together for, well, this year.
I know.
Yeah.
It must have been a great relief for you, actually.
Well, my ears are a little, in better health, but yes.
He's so rude. Nosotha Higid, here we are, live, as it were. Well, are you live?
I'm as live as I can be.
As ever he has been. And I have to say, I'm loving the jumper.
Are you?
Yes.
It's nice and round, with like my shape. Yeah? Noel.
There is a story behind this, actually. We are live from Lyndon Christian Centre with wonderful Andy Hunter, our sound engineer. Big shout out and a wonderful thank you to the trustees and everybody who's made this possible. Fantastic to have Jeff down here in Swansea with his passport to get over the Baglan Bridge. And I have to say, we had a phone call this afternoon. They had a flood here on Friday. There's no heating. But actually, it feels great, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's fine. So it's a needs must. I've got my thermal drawers on and we're ready to go. So we're going to take you back now. Hopefully, over the next hour and a half or so, we're going to wend our way through a few centuries, actually. And we go now to a chap called Max Reger, who didn't actually come up with very much at all of note. But he did come up with this absolute gem of a lullaby called the Marian Wiegenlied.
Sommer, 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 Somm
you know, I was thinking, it's very lovely, actually, just having you and myself and Andy here, but it's quite weird, you know, as two people who have tiny egos, you know, and who like a bit of applause, yeah, to not have any applause. And I did think about asking Andy to provide some canned laughter so that we could sound like a really bad, yeah, 80s sitcom, like Robin's Nest or...
I don't remember them.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, well... Or, I don't know, mind your language. That was another dreadful, yeah, one, wasn't, yeah, it? But I thought, no, we'll go without and we'll manage. The other thing I should say, look, I've got to stand on my cross, 2 metre social distance and not disappearing off the edge of the camera also. The other thing I have to say is a lot of Christmas music is very gentle, isn't it?
You know,
and very beautiful and reflective because it's a very special time of year for all sorts of reasons. This year, I understand it's going to be harder. For some people, it's been a hard year as it is, but Jeff and I are here to bring you some Christmas jangle and spangle. But spangles.
I love spangles. They were in the shape of tunes.
They were.
But they weren't menthol, they were fruit flavoured. I loved spangles.
They might even have been, were there cola spangles as well, or is that something I've made up?
I think there were.
Okay.
Yeah.
And pacers, but that's another story for another day. So we could do a sweet themed evening, but not tonight. I was looking for different repertoire that was maybe a little bit more uplifting, and just some general stuff. And then, ta-da! Like my encyclopedic friend, who is sitting on my right hand, says to me, "Oh, I've got something that I wrote a couple of years ago. Do you want to have a look at it? It's a setting of Love Came Down at Christmas, ladies and gentlemen." You will not be disappointed. Love came down at Christmas, at Christmas. Love, oh love, love divine. Love to God and all men. Love of peace and gift and sign. Came down at Christmas, love, oh lovely love divine. Love was born at Christmas, stars and angels gave the sign. Love was born at Christmas, love, oh Christmas, stars and angels gave the sign. Love shall be our token, our token. Love, oh lovely love divine. Love to God and all men. Peace and gift and love. Worship with a goddess, love, oh lovely love divine. Worship with a goddess, but with a summer sign, sign. Thank you. Well, I don't care if there's no audience.
Well, right back at you.
Oh, let's big each other up, shall we? It's fantastic. Okay, so I think you'll agree that's a keeper. That's a keeper. As I hope you'll think is the next number. As you know, usually for the last, at least 13 years, because Fionn came on stage when she was 3 weeks old. So I reckon 15 years, yes. So she came on when she was 3 weeks old, her birthday's December the 6th. And I was on the Brangwyn Hall stage twice, actually, that year. Once with you for the Dunvant Annual.
Right.
And once on the 23rd of December with the Chamber Orchestra of Wales, which I've been doing, as I say, for 15 years. Unfortunately, it's not happening this year, but next year, book your seats, it's going to happen. And Alwyn, I'm really lucky because he chooses a lot of the repertoire and he comes up with these little gems. And this is a setting of the Ave Maria in Spanish by William Gomez.
Gomez. Yeah, just like the...
Not that Gomez, darling. Yes, so Gomez is like Jones. And if you look up the number of William Gomez's who were composer, it's very difficult to tell which one it was. You can kind of guess by listening to the harmonies, but I don't know if it's William Gomez the elder, the younger, the larger, the less large, the lesser.
Hope we'll do it justice.
I think so.
That's a new one on me.
Oh, where?
Did you forget the words in the middle? Is that why you did that humming kind of stuff?
Well, if it's good enough for Puccini.
Yeah, the humming chorus from Madame Butterfly.
There you go, you see. And if, do you know what? When we meet here with Musical Memories Choir, Choir for People Living with Dementia and Their Carers, we do a lot of 60s and 70s things. There are more la-las and shoo-bops than you can shake a stick at.
I don't care. I think it's all, as long as you're getting these people singing and enjoying themselves, yep. That's what it's all about.
I agree. Okay, a little bit of Michael Head now. Now, Michael Head, I think, is it?
Is it? Yes, it is.
Excellent. So, a little bit of Michael Head. Michael Head was writing about 100 years ago, and he was one of a cohort of amazing English composers, of whom John Ireland, Geoffrey Bush, Roger Quilter, Finzi,
Stanford, Vaughan Williams,
so many of them. The last bit of Elgar, you know, and it was an incredible time in music. And I think actually the evolution of English music through the beginning of last century was a tremendous thing. It went for about the first 40 years of just churning out like a machine. You know,
but they took beautiful texts, you see.
They did.
And around that time, there were people writing beautiful items of prose and poetry, and they had a lovely foundation to compose their songs with.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And of course, that was this thing that we've spoken about before, haven't we? About shutting out the badness of the world and writing something idealistic. Ivan Novello did it, Rodgers and Hammerstein did it. How can we make the world of music sparkly and shiny when everything else is glum and drab? And anyway, Michael Head wrote this very simple, beautiful melody, and it's very interesting. It's called The Little Road to Bethlehem. So here we are walking along the little road to Bethlehem, but actually at the beginning you don't know, unless you've seen the title, that you're on the road to Bethlehem. And the narrative of the story is a lovely, peaceful, tranquil, melodic line, and the walking is in the piano.
Sleep, my little king.
Isn't that lovely?
It just transports you, doesn't it?
It definitely does.
And all the imagery is there. You hear the sheep bell, and you're talking about the lambs, and they're tired at the end of the day, aren't they? So, yeah, it's nice to do music of that era, because it really does exactly what you said. It just transports you to another place.
Definitely. So we go to French repertoire now, but we're going to we're going to sing it in English because everybody knows it in English. It's not me copping out, honestly, because I je parle peu de français and all that. But honestly, if I said to you Joyeux Noël, it could be anything. If I say to you Oh Holy Night, then you know where we are. This has been covered by more people than I care to think of, sometimes better than others. It's been sung in more keys than I care to think of.
Which key should we do it in tonight?
Oh, let's do it in D major, shall we?
I can play it in D.
You just said to me you don't like black notes. I tell you what, eh? Black notes.
There's two in here, this one.
Okay, so long as we've got that sorted, thank goodness I'm here, that's all I say. So this is, ladies and gentlemen, Oh Holy Night.
Shining, it is the night of the
like the Perry Como version of stuff. I do.
I'm not old enough to remember Perry Como.
Oh, steady now. Come on, you're 3 weeks older than me and you know that. Right, okay, I have to say, you'd be relieved that I'm not singing in the next one. I'm going to sit behind the piano and pretend that I can play, when actually you all know I can't. And I'm going to leave you in the hands of my lovely friend.
Well, do you know, there are so many wonderful pieces of music and melodies that we You all right there?
Fine, thanks, yeah.
That we associate with Christmas. One of my favourite melodies is a German, or maybe Austrian, tune called Still, Still, Still. So I'm just going to amble around on the keys with this beautiful melody. I'm sure you'll recognise it. Thank you. Thank you all.
Please, I'm here now. Please yes. Come on. Can I do a duet with you and then I'll be able to say I accompanied Jeff Howard?
Okay, well, what would you like to do?
I don't know. I can play two fingers. I don't know.
Pick a tune.
I like Silent Night.
Silent Night?
Yeah.
What key would you like to do it in? You've got 12, maybe 13 to choose from.
I don't know. I quite like G flat. No. No.
F, silent night. G. Shall I? G.
A flat. A. You choose.
C. Shall I play the introduction? Completely unrehearsed. Just woke the baby Jesus up with that last chord.
Okay. Thanks for that. I'll put it on my CV. Accompanied Jeffrey Howard Esquire. Now then, for those of you who are not familiar with this bit of trivia, the next song was written by Thora Hird's son-in-law.
Really?
Yeah, Mel Torme.
Well.
Wrote Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire.
And Jeff's believe, what?
Chestnuts.
Oh.
And believe me...
Sorry, I...
And believe me, if you Googled the Christmas song, you've got an awful lot of stuff to pile through. But this is the...
This is the one.
The Christmas song, yeah. So they tell me.
Gosh, there's a lot of... accidentals in this arrangement, Ros.
I think they're called incidentals, darling.
Okay, we'll try and make an incident out of them. Here we go.
Yes. although it's been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. We can thank Mr. Bubbles for that.
That's the hardest thing I've sight read this year. I honestly know.
Your brain's either wired for jazz.
I can't play jazz. I said that now, I can't play jazz.
Well, you just did.
Well, I tried.
It was lush, man. I loved it. You watch, you'll bring the house down. I bet Helen's manning the keyboard back at home to see if they've see if we get any comments, like tell her to put
Jeffrey Howard
in it.
Doesn't play jazz. There you go.
I think you're fine if he does. Okay, from the sublime to the ridiculous. It's very strange because Jeff and I, as you know, as well as being musicians, we like to think of ourselves somewhat as educators, and we're involved with youth and all that. And they quite often will come in and say, I'm going to sing Ave Maria. And you say, excellent, which Ave Maria? And they go, Ave Maria. And sometimes they'll say Ave Maria by Celine Dion.
She writes lovely Ave Maria, she does.
It's a lovely Ave Maria Celine. Anyway, so, and of course they forget that it's part of the Mass and it's been set probably about 6,000 times, if not more, especially by the jobbing composers back in the day who just used to have to make things a little bit more interesting to stop people going off the beaten track. This is one of the more familiar ones. It's by Schubert. So this is Schubert's Ave Maria. Thank you. Did you know your mother played that for me once in St Mary the Immaculate?
My mother? No, I did not know that.
Yeah.
In Cardiff?
Yeah, you were supposed to be playing, but you were having an abscess done in the dentist. I don't think it was your diverticulitis on that occasion.
No.
I turned up and there she was.
There she was.
Mrs. Howard Senior.
Well, I hope she used more than the two fingers I've only ever heard her play the piano with. That's all I can say.
No, actually, I think she played the hymns. I think I sang it unaccompanied. But it was a joy to see her, as it always is.
Well, okay.
And if they do catch up with this, I'm going to say hello to them because they are brilliant people. They might catch up with it. If they're really, really badly behaved, Jeff might show them as a... Yes.
This is your New Year's penance.
Yes, exactly. This is instead of the Queen. Right, OK. Now then, Berlioz. I'm going to tell you about Berlioz. He was mainly not very good at harmonising. He read a book. Did you know this?
I didn't.
By Rameau. Why would you read a book on harmonisation by Rameau? Perhaps it was the only one around at the time. Perhaps when you went to the library in Paris, the shelves were not laden with harmonisation books. So he read a book by Rameau on harmony, and he didn't get it. He didn't understand it. He never learned to play the keyboard. He was quite a good guitarist. But actually, if you listen to most of what he's written, his harmonies work not well. And I believe am I right in saying that you actually don't like this piece of music, or at least you didn't historically as a child?
I didn't as a child. No, I mean the orchestration of it. The introduction is played by the oboes, and if the oboes aren't particularly in tune, I mean, you never hear of an oboe choir, do you? You never hear of more than two oboes ever together, and that's the reason why.
Okay, letters in writing to Geoffrey.
I'll tell Berlioz when I see him. We might not be going to the same place, but there you go.
Yeah, yes. So anyway, but I have to say this. It's from L'Enfance du Christ. And I quite like this. I quite like it as a choral piece. All right?
Okay.
I'm just saying that. Okay, just been out there. Okay. Thank you. Monsieur Hugo.
I'll tell you about Rameau once we've finished.
Oh, please.
Well, interested. No, let's get this over and done with first.
Okay.
Right, here we go.
Babe, all mortal babes exile.
So go on, because you only do about an afternoon's worth of work on Cooper and Rameau when you're at university.
Yes, you do.
And the rest of it is Schenkerian analysis.
Apparently, well, Rameau, of course, was a French Baroque composer, and he used to beat time with a staff.
Yes.
And he used to bang it down on the floor like this. And of course, music of that period was all based on dance music. So there were lots of downbeats. And he would reiterate where all the downbeats are and this, that and the other. But unfortunately, one day, his foot got in the way of the staff and he brought it down quickly on his foot and it got infected and he got gangrene and that was the end of Rameau.
True. And that's how the baton came about.
Because they then said, right, we're not having anybody beating staffs down on the on their feet. So we have the baton, and now it's in the end. And now we conduct like this.
And we can poke you if you...
if you are trop, that's the singers.
Oh, I do you know what? I love an anecdote. Very good. And who knew there was anything interesting to say about Rameau? Okay, now then, don't laugh. This is by the same man who wrote Underground, Overground, Wombling Free, isn't it?
I don't remember the Rombles. Everything you say you remember, I don't remember.
He's such a fibber. You remembered Spangles, that's all I'm saying. So, yes, and it's a really, really lovely song. It was made famous by David Essex. The lyrics are by Tim Rice. Excuse me, the lyrics are by Tim Rice. And I don't know... it's very difficult singing crossover stuff because you never know if it's just teetering on the brink of not great and a little bit... Can I use the word naff on a Sunday night?
I'm sure
you can. In a place
of
worship.
In this 20th century, we can use the word naff to describe a piece of music. Why not?
So when I said to Jeff, I said, Winter's Tale, what do you think? He said, I think it's an absolutely lovely song. Let's give it a go. It is A Winter's Tale.
Just another winter's tale.
Now, you see, if I had that, bright eyes, an underground, overground, wambling free, as a composer in my repertoire, I could go to my grave happy, I think.
You could. You could. What about that? What was the song from the film Arthur?
Once in your life you'll find him. Do you like that?
I do like that.
That's a good song, that is.
Yeah.
Marvin Hamlisch, he comes up with some good ones as well.
Yeah.
Way We Were.
Yeah.
Nobody Does It Better.
Nobody. Should we make a list? Let's make a list. Where's my pencil? Let's fit all of those into another concert.
Now, I tell you, who else can write a tune, apart from you? That nice Randy Newman.
Oh, I was reaching for the Handel Messiah score then, and then she said Randy Newman. I wouldn't know Randy Newman if he poked me in the eye with a sharp stick.
Okay, Simon Smith and his Amazing Dancing Bear.
Nope, not a clue.
When She Loved Me.
Nope.
You've Got a Friend in Me.
Yes.
Ah, you've obviously been out when the kids have been on the 47th replay of Toy Story.
Yes, I put my headphones on for that.
Yes, I'm listening, darlings. Anyway, so look, here we are, and it is that time of year when by now Jeff and I probably would have done about 15 Messiahs each. I can't say that by the last one, I'm not sorry that it's the last one.
They're exhausting.
But I do love them, and I do love a Messiah, and I'm sure there are lots of choristers watching for whom it will have been a great shame that they haven't been able to sing and to us and all the other lovely things. So we're going to give you a little bit of Messiah. We're just going to have a bit of a jaunt through Rejoice Greatly.
Okay.
Thank you. Hours up that drafty loft when you haven't done the hoovering and Mrs. Howard has sent you up there.
Yes. What, practicing, do you mean? Or... Have we ever done a Messiah together?
Yes, in the Brangwen.
Was I there?
Well, in body, yes.
I think, I was on the organ, but I was only just playing chords, wasn't I? I wasn't playing all that other
stuff.
And
we've done one in Penclouth.
I don't remember any of this.
But you know what? It's very strange because that's happening to me a lot recently. And people go, yes, you remember that church you sang in? I have no recollection. And it's terrible. And I don't think it's age. I just think it's new number of concerts, possibly. Yeah. I'm a bit the same with theatres. When I get there, I can't remember how to get there, and I have to envisage the stage door to make sure I go down the right road. What's I going to do? I know, Jeff and I, as most of you know, Jeff and I met when I was a postgraduate student at Royal Welsh College of Music and Drama, and I had a really, really lovely coach at the time before Jeff, whose name was Courtney Kenny. Now, not a lot of people know that Courtney Kenny's middle name was Kenny.
He was Courtney Kenny Kenny?
Yeah, he was. Courtney Kenneth Kenny.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so Courtney Kenny Kenny. So we had a lot of comedy names because we also had a head of course whose real name was Robert Joyce. And Robert Joyce had been an organist, hadn't he, at Llandaff, a very fine organist, I believe. But for some reason, again, people called him, as it happens sometimes, by his middle name, which was Harry. So he was actually Harry Joyce, Harry Joyce, Harry... See? And that's not a made-up. We used to sing it at him, and he entered into the spirit with great...
Well...
patronising.
An organist with a sense of humour.
Well, that's two of you, then.
That's two of us.
Very nice man. Right, where are we going now? Thomas Dunhill.
Yes.
Thomas Dunhill, famously known for his setting of The Cloths of Heaven. Now, Jeff and I sing Carl Jenkins' version of that and the Dilys Elwyn Edwards. You won't remember that either because because that was more than 3 weeks ago. So we do that. But this is his less known song. It's called To the Queen of Heaven. I hope you like it. It's absolutely beautiful.
To
Now, tell me honestly, in the stretch of your 5 years as a professional organist and pianist since graduating, have you ever played that?
Never. I've never heard it before in my life.
Incredible, isn't it? No, but that's incredible, isn't it? Because it's a great... Well,
lovely.
I think it's a great song.
Yeah, it is a great song.
Great song. Okay, from the Sublime... No, it's not actually from the Sublime to the Ridiculous, because it is something still in keeping. These are all in keeping, aren't they, I hope, with Christmas. This, however, is often mistaken for being a sad song. Have you come across that interpretation of it?
I have, yes.
And it's not a sad song.
No, it's got a great overtone. You're going to explain what it's all about.
Yeah, well...
It does make you feel... It makes you feel comfy, cosy when you acknowledge what the text is all about.
I think so. So, my hymian hwyr y ddinas yn fy neffro. There's a buzz in my head. The city in my head is constantly making sounds, as well as, you know, at the parallels with the outside world. And what it was written by somebody who used to travel a lot and had a terrible, whose partner had a terrible fear of being away from home, being in airport lounges, travelling, worrying that they weren't ever going to get home and see their family again. And so somebody wrote this, and all they said was, "And von Avangel, I'll send an angel to look after you." That's all it is. It's that kind of feeling that we all need, because we both work away. Andy works away from home a lot. You just need that feeling that somebody's keeping an eye on you when you're away, and you're going to get home and see your kids and your family soon, isn't it? So it's that rather than anything being, you know, too morose. There you go. Here we go.
Oh,
Thanks, matey. I think it's all yours again.
It is my go. My turn.
Ooh, just tripped over something.
Now, here's a lovely song. And it really... I have just an image of this, I think, from last Christmas or maybe even the Christmas before, of all our troops who are abroad coming home for Christmas, or their family sending messages to them so they don't feel that they're quite so alone at Christmas time. Carrying on with the same theme as the song we've just done. This is a beautiful number called I'll Be Home for Christmas. Thank you.
Love it. There are going to be so many happy people in Swansea and the surrounding areas that camera is trained on your hands, because it's very funny. Whenever we do concerts, usually down at All Saints, everybody chooses to sit on the bride's side so that they can watch his fingers when he's playing, because it is absolutely fantastic. Okay, now then... further gorgeousness from Mr. Howard, because I have a confession. I decided to put this Ivan Novello piece in at the last minute. My Ivan Novello book never, ever leaves my side. It's never very far away, because I'm always referring it to it for different things, particularly now that it's included on the Associated Boards, the Royal Schools of Music.
Is it?
Voice
at
syllabus.
Last.
At last, exactly.
At last.
Not necessarily this one, but a lot of the other ones are. And I, for some reason, I can't find it. And I think one of my students has gone off with it. So I said to him about 5 minutes before we were due to come on, I said, I want to put in, I can give you the starlight. Are you okay with that? He said, what key? I went, I don't know. You're the musician. I'm just a singer. So here it is. I can give you the starlight. Take it away. Thank you, dear. Thank you to you all for joining us this evening. We're just going to a few more numbers before we round up. Really hope you've enjoyed. Don't know if you've been feeding back any comments to Helen or Andy, but if you are enjoying, that's wonderful. All good. Thumbs up from the man in the mask. Thank you very, very much. If you wish to contribute, there is a GoFund link if you want to make a small contribution to this evening. It'd be absolutely wonderful. Helps us cover our costs. Now we're going to have a little bit of Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
A Merry Little Christmas.
Make the Yuletide gay.
Is it me, or does Christmas bring out the best in songwriters?
Oh, absolutely. Some lovely chords in there, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, great. Really, really good. Yeah. What's your favourite... Oh, I'm putting you on the spot. What is your favourite Christmas film? Or don't you have one? Grinch.
Well, Grinch. I quite like The Polar Express.
Oh, yes. I bet you like the soundtrack.
It is exactly for the soundtrack.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, brilliant.
Who's it by, sorry? Who's the soundtrack?
Silvestri, is okay, it? Alan yeah. Silvestri. Okay. And I do also like Santa Claus the movie.
Yes.
That's the one, with Dudley Moore as an elf.
He's very good yeah. in everything that he yeah. ever did.
And again, I think it's because of the soundtrack.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. And have you watched Elf?
I watched it this afternoon.
Right, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Very good soundtrack there
yeah.
as well.
Yeah.
Pennies That's from Heaven.
Yeah.
And a Brenda Lee Sleigh... Sleigh Ride, I think. Oh,
yeah.
Yes. Let It Snow, I think it was. Brilliant. Okay, so I think I'm right in saying that we've got another bit of Rutter coming up. Am I right?
A bit of Rutter, yes.
Now, John Rutter, I didn't realise until Fionn did a PowerPoint on him in music the other day. You know these kids, how they do PowerPoints without even thinking about it. I wouldn't know where to start. And she came home and she said, I did two PowerPoints today, one on Beethoven and one on John Rutter. And one of them was Born Above a Pub in Peckham. And I said, probably not Ludwig van Beethoven then.
No, not
but
Beethoven.
But I would have put my money, I would have put every last penny on saying that he was a posh lad, went to Harrow, came up through that. But no, he lived above a pub when his parents were pulling pints downstairs.
That's fine.
Good
yeah.
man.
I'm Excellent. All for it.
I like him even more.
You
but
do.
He does love Christmas.
He does.
And he does get Christmas.
It's not Christmas unless you've heard a little bit of Rutter.
A little bit of Rutter. And here is a little bit of Rutter. And Jeff and I, we wish you Christmas.
Thank you.
wish you starlight on fields of snow, the winter's morning light and evening's glow. I wish you candles that shine from every tree, so all the world can see the light that there could be. I wish you music, I wish you song, with voices singing joyous and strong. I wish you melody singing loud and clear. I wish you Christmas, a merry Christmas, and may your Christmases remind you. Christmas bring you all your heart's desire. I wish you children to make the season new, that all your dreams come true, just like they did for you. I wish you loved ones, I wish you far, with angel voices from the absolutely sublime to the rather tragic, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know how it is. Some people are a bit unlucky in love, aren't they?
Yes.
And, I had high hopes for this one.
Yeah.
But, let me tell you about it. All went a bit wrong.
First day after Christmas, my true love and I had a fight. And so I chopped the pear tree down and burnt it just for spite. And with a single cartridge, I shot that ruddy partridge. My true love gave to me. Second day after Christmas, I pulled on the old rubber gloves and very gently wrung the neck of both the turtle doves. My true love, my true love, my true love gave to me. The third day after Christmas, my mother caught the croup. I had to make three French hens to make some chicken soup. The four calling birds were a big mistake, and their language was obscene. The five gold rings were completely fake, and they turned my fingers green. The sixth day after Christmas, the six laying geese wouldn't lay. I sent the whole damn gaggle to the RSPCA. On the eighth day's ache, what a day, I found all seven of the swimming swans that drowned. My true love, my true love, my true love gave to me. The eighth day after Christmas, before they could suspect, I gathered up the eight maids a-milking, nine ladies dancing, 10 drummers drumming, 11 pipers piping, 12 lords a-leaping. Well, actually, I kept one of the drummers.
Just one?
Just one. Roger. And sent it back, Colette. I said, my true love, we are through love, and I'll say in so many words, furthermore, your Christmas gifts are for the birds. Tragic, really.
Yeah, I know. It's a bit wordy, that one, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, you want to be in my brain. It's like Fraggle Rock. I'm not kidding. You wouldn't remember that either, would you?
No, no, no.
So, as I say, diolch yn fawr I chi gyd. A thank you once again to wonderful Andy. He's so patient, bless him. To his lovely wife, Helen, for setting up all this loveliness for us this evening so we can have a little bit of festive sparkle, bring it into your homes, to the trustees. And just to you guys for supporting Jeff and I over a long, long time. Not so long for Jeff, but obviously a long time for me. And we really appreciate your support. And we know that this year has been really, really tricky. We call ourselves humoresque because we like to have a little bit of a jibe at the profession that we're in, because it's not hard carrying, and it's, you know, it's not rocket science, and it's not brain surgery. But, you know, we have a bit of a prod at it, but this year has been hard, I think, for a lot of musicians. And so for us to be able to come here and sing and actually see each other, which is really nice, because we would have seen each other a lot during the past year. So to actually see each other in person and to make live music and to bring it into our homes, I feel personally very privileged. And this is the point at which I say I'm incredibly lucky to have sitting on my right hand an amazing musician, one of my very, very dearest friends. And he actually, I've said this for years and years, he actually makes me sound much, much better than I am. He's very good on his own, but I sort of feel like I'm in the way when I'm singing, but he's tremendous. And I know you're all going to applaud from your house. Wildly, woo! Okay, now this is where we do a gag, yeah?
And you, I forgot.
But we can't. So I can do contactless.
Okay.
There you go.
Contactless.
There you go, contactless. You see, what happens is I talk nice about him and then he gives me a tenner. So, but contactless.
A tenner? What was on the thing then? Contactless.
Anyway, it was another O on the end of that.
Oh.
We're very proud in South West Wales to have had a gentleman in our midst when we were growing up. Those of you who were raised in Swansea will have definitely seen him at the Panto. Absolutely hilarious man called Ryan Davis. His partnership, there he is, his partnership with Ronnie Williams was one that was about to take Great Britain by storm. They were being hailed as the Welsh Morecambe and Wise, and they had just secured a contract with the BBC after years of doing Voix Vie, Don't Call Will on Your Father, all that kind of stuff, which just used to make us roll about. One of these men who made a bit like Les Dawson, made a very, very good woman. And he was very, very good at that. And they'd secured a contract. And then, I don't want to put a dampener on everything, but he was on tour in America. And unfortunately, his life was cut short. And we lost an absolute shining star. Thankfully, before he went, he left us an amazing legacy of songs like Pan Fo'r Noson Hir, Blodwyn a Mary, Tia Doddonia, and this one, which is called Nadolig Pwy a Wy. Now, actually, Nadolig Pwy a Wy sort of means, what is it? You know, what's it mean? What's it all about, sort of thing? And it starts, you'll understand, because Welsh for tinsel actually is tinsel. So it starts, tinsel ar y goeden, tinsel on the tree, seren yn y nen, the stars, a dolly fach yn eistedd, morddel a friga pren, and the little doll is sitting prettily under the tree. And it goes on then and develops to the end where he says, nid oes yn gofyn pawb a oer, because we all really know what the true meaning of Christmas is, and this is Nadolig Pwy a Wy'r.
Tinsel ar y goeden, seren yn y nen, a dolly fach yn eistedd, morddel ar frig y pren.
Nadolig Llawen.